Christ is born. We rejoice in Emmanuel, God with us. The promise has been fulfilled, and we can rejoice in the faithfulness of Almighty God. Our annual celebration reminds us not to take divine gifts for granted. Last year, we were slowly readjusting and renewing our Christmas celebrations in a post-pandemic world. Things seemed to be more positive, and we might have been lulled into a notion of normalcy. However, the gospel is always living and challenges us to grow in our love of Almighty God and to manifest that love in our concern and concrete dealings with every human person. The shepherds heard the announcement of the birth of the Savior and went in haste to find the child Jesus. That is the first lesson for us. We pause in prayer before the manger, but we also move, go forth, and tell others about Him who makes all things new. No authentic believer remains in the same place. Rather, he or she goes forth and shares the good news that has been revealed. Certainly, we share the good tidings through our generosity to those in need and those societies that help them. We reach out to those who might be alone at this time of year. For example, I will travel and spend Christmas in Central Europe because a portion of the flock entrusted to my pastoral care is on mission there. I want to encourage them, assure them of my interest and that of the entire global archdiocese for the military services of the United States of America. You and I also pray to Jesus Christ for authentic, lasting peace in Ukraine, Haiti, the Middle East, Africa, and everywhere else where the message of the Prince of Peace has not yet changed mentalities, fostered dialogue, and renewed relationships. On the vigil of 2023, we should be able to sit down and resolve our differences without resorting to weapons. We want to recapture the notion that we are part of one human family, as Pope Francis reminded us in Fratelli Tutti. Jesus Christ was born among us to save us from sin, to show us an authentic way to live, and to call us to continual conversion and everlasting life. As we rejoice in His birth, let us allow divine life in us to transform us. I wish you a happy Christmas.